Welcome to the Carl the Hipster Prepper bird page, the most exciting bird watching page on YouTube. Watch as my suet conquers all the corporate suet as we go to Valhalla.
Buddy, this is Carl the Hipster Prepper here, and welcome to another episode of the Bird Suet Challenge. Today's competitor, we have a brand from the Royal Wing Company, which is made by Tractor Supply, and it's called Peanut Suet. And let's see, it's got a blue jay on the cover. Looks like a little blue jay sitting on a deck eating some peanuts, so that's good. Let's see directions to use. It says to place in a basket, hang approximately 5 feet from the ground, not for human consumption, store in a refrigerator or freezer for ease of use, wash your hands after fill and feeder. Well, that's pretty common sense. Allergy warning, peanuts, it may contain tree nuts, wheat, soy, and fish and all that other stuff. It does have peanuts, so if you have a peanut allergy, I would recommend not using this stuff. But like I said, they always put the other things too about, their generic stuff. The generic warnings. It says satisfaction guaranteed. If you're not completely happy with, not completely satisfied with your purchase, please return to any Tractor Supply Company store. Okay, that's cool. That's good to know. Let's see for ingredients. Let's see. This stuff right here contains rendered beef suet. That's good. Peanuts. Good. Peanut meal. Good. Cracked corn. Good. Now the thing is this right here appears to be a good suet for, a good bird suet for the area I live in the woods on the side of a mountain, inside the Appalachian Mountains and in West Virginia. So this will probably be a good suet for the birds out here. Let's open this up and see what we got inside. So let's see. If I can do this delicately. So let's see. Let's look at this stuff, okay? Let's get the light here. Well, I think I see full chunks of peanut butter. Use my little plumbers, use scissors for this. I think I see full chunks of peanuts, so that's good. See some corn. And I see some little specks here, so I guess that's maybe split peanut butter, split peanuts. And for peanut meal, I'm guessing it's going to taste like peanut butter, or maybe it's like peanut, peanut powder. Let's take a little taste, see what this stuff tastes like. Yes, I do taste the peanuts in it. It kind of tastes like a real non-sweetened peanut butter. And you also have the beef suet, which, it's a fatty beef taste. But overall, I think the stuff's actually not too bad. I mean, the only opinion I would have is that instead of using corn, I mean, it'd be cool to use some sunflower seeds, but, that's what I would do. That's my personal recommendation. But I'm sure Tractor Supply has a brand of suet that is made this way. But anyways, let's put this on the scale and see how much it weighs in at. Because that's one thing I like to do. I like to see if we're getting our money's worth. Okay, so I got the light there. Let's zero out the scale. Get it set to zero. So it's at zero. Now this package, make sure you get all the residue on there. So this package, I guess the label weighs 2 grams. So this one here says that this weight should be 311 grams. All right. Now let's drop this on the scale and see what we got here. Let's do a little push, nice and easy. Come out nice and easy. Oh, don't want to lose that. So 331. Oh, see, we got that 332. So it looks like we're teetering between, I'll call it 332. See, let's zero out again. So basically right here, this suet weighs 331 grams. I'll call it 332. It's teetering there. I'll call it 332 because there is a little bit left in the package. And the package says we got 311 grams. So we got an extra, 21 grams. Not a bad deal. Now let's compare this to the competitor. This is my... for those who haven't seen before, this is my Carl the Hipster brand suet. Sorry, brand, just make it myself. And there's a web page. I have YouTubes. I think I have 2 YouTubes on how to make this suet. My stuff is the best. May I think it's the best because I'm a prepper? May I think it's best because I think I'm a hipster? Or maybe it is the best. I don't know. That's for your opinion. But anyways, my stuff is always does well because I am the best at making suet. And my suet, just for the heads up, it's made from lard, not suet. Basically, suet's beef fat. Lard is pig fat. And pig fat has a lower melting point, so it's used for cooking. That's why I use it, because it's available at... It's available in the baking section of most stores. It's relatively cheap. It comes in 4-pound or 1-pound containers. And if you get the 4-pound container, you pop it into a bowl, like a big, you know, a big microwave container, and you can microwave it, and it's so easy to work with. Basically, beef suet, I've used it before. You got to cook it down. It's kind of a pain. My suet also contains peanuts and peanut butter. I also have black oil sunflower seeds. I also have other assorted nuts and berries from a woodpecker blend feed I got. I think I got either got it at Walmart or Tractor Supply. It's one of or Southern States. One of those places like that. And then I also have mealworms in here. And then I also have all kinds of berries. So I have like. Cranberries, raisins, figs, raisins, figs, cherries, pineapple, and then I have dehydrated strawberries, dehydrated apples, dehydrated pineapple. Dehydrated pears. All kind of. I also got other stuff in there too. And the thing with work with lard is, if you just use lard by itself, and you make a suet out of it, because I did it before. And what happens is it's always kind of runny. It never really gets hard. So in order to thicken it up, I use cornmeal, and I use oatmeal to thicken it up. Like I said, you can use flour too, but I got a real good deal on cornmeal. I guess I'm a cornmeal prepper. I did that even before the pandemic, but you know, that's the prepper side of me coming in. Actually, I just found a good deal and I just store it. But anyways, enough of me rambling. Let's get this stuff out in the feeder and let's see what happens.